time was when man lived in close communion with nature. There was unique harmony and connection, one of the valuable coexistence of man, animals, and plant lives. Life for none of these was a burden then. They were content to breathe the pure air, enjoy the blessings of the sunlight and pure water. As Mahatma Ji wished, all beings lived simply, so that others would simply live. Life became unusually complex over the ages as every successive generation ruthlessly exploited the resources of the universe. The only way we can tide over the crisis is to restore the connectedness, renewing afresh our bonds with nature and unconditionally loving the plants, animals, and the ecosystem. Our Mother Earth has boundless reserves of care and affection for us. She is infinite patience. The forests form the lungs of our planet. But we are hell-bent on damaging it as heavily as we can. Deforestation, soil degradation, desertification, acid rain, and wildfires. The ruthless exploitation for our material gains. When we pollute the air, the water, and the streams by the residues of our exploiting industry, we don't even spare the sea. Cruelty needs no definition. It is born the moment we ignore other living entities. Every form of life is the work of the Creator and has the part of the Creator within it. Every life has its role, its own particularities, traits, specific role and purpose in the scheme of things. It is not just the catastrophic effects of climate change, which slowly and painfully condemn many species to death, but also the human interference with them. Man's greedy move of expansion leaves no room for other creatures. Animals run amok, yearning for a bite, even as we lavish water and dump bulks of unused food every day. Man should know that he does not have complete dominion over plants and animals. Rather, he should coexist with them. We must relate ourselves to them. We should honor and respect the sacredness of their lives and being. Man and nature interact dialectically in such a way that, as society develops, man tends to become less dependent on nature directly. But what happens indirectly, his dependence grows all the more. This right relation is vital for today if we sincerely wish to save our planet. This is why COHEART has come up with propagating the One Health concept. Man's unobtrusive, simple life was gradually to give way for development and change. Development of small technologies steadily gathered momentum, and there was no way for him to adapt life to the changes initiated. With mechanization came abundant food production. Quantity replaced quality. From villages, men moved to cities in the most favorable locations. Concentration of lives in the cities created a need for public administration and division of labor. Gradually, however, people became increasingly dependent upon technologies and less dependent upon nature's generosities. Inevitably, the links were severed. At each step of cultural expansion, the natural physical landscapes were increasingly modified. The new habitations, new diseases began to pose threats. Every day, thousands of children and adults die from underdiagnosed diseases that have arisen at the human-animal-environment interface. While zoonosis represents a significant emerging threat to public health, many of these diseases, such as diarrheal diseases arising from poor water sanitation, are being neglected. Population is continuing to increase rapidly, while many vital resources such as energy, soil, and clean, safe water resources are depleting. Man has always killed animals for food. His relish for animal flesh has long history. But in the good old days, even killing had a kind of sanctity, in contrast with our present practices. The astonishingly increasing number of animals slaughtered, the horrible conditions in which they are bred, the tremendous inequalities in food distribution across the planet. We are fortunate enough to have animals to feed us. We can't do without their meat, milk, and eggs. Don't we give them at least a decent natural life as a token of gratitude? The purity and safety of our food is being increasingly scrutinized and questioned by the public. The foodborne illnesses are already a grave global problem. The application of a One Health model, where potential solutions are viewed and delivered more holistically and with an emphasis on prevention, is a compelling and timely strategy. Health is the ability of an individual or a social group to modify himself or itself continually, not only in order to function better in the present, but also to prepare for the future. Remember, the earth is our home. Nature, plants, and animals are not just them. They are part of us. We are not the only inhabitants on the planet. Neither are plants and animals created with the sole purpose of being used by us. We coexist in a common abode, a harmonious community. One Health is aimed at harmony among man, animal, and nature. Please join us in this good cause. Learn about One Health through the PG Diploma and Certificate courses offered by the university. You can also become a free member of COHEART's One Health portal and get actively involved in future One Health activities. To know about us further, please visit us at www.cohart.ac.in.